So Liu Kang and Katana are attacked by the only robot who wears dreads as they continue through another action sequence where people are just jumping around on strings. It's like Crouching Tiger, Hidden bullshit. There's so many strings in this movie, I keep thinking there's a puppet master at the top of the screen.
Pull the string! Pull the string!
But then they're saved by a familiar face, Sub-Zero. Well, wait a minute, didn't he freeze to death in the first movie?
You killed my older brother.
Oh, that was his brother, 7 degrees Celsius. Okay, I get it now.
You killed my older brother.
So why did you help us?
Because I hated him. He was a douche.
We have a common enemy, Sub-Zero. You must help us.
No, wait a minute. She just called him Sub-Zero. Okay. Maybe it was Scorpion, the yellow guy who was the brother in the first film that died. Okay, now that makes sense. So, who are they going to encounter next? We saw both of these guys die in the first movie! Why are they suddenly back? Did they both have brothers? Are they themselves brothers? Are they clones? Are they the same people but different actors? All the other actors are different, so how am I supposed to tell? I follow lectures on black hole theories less complicated than this! Amidst all the fighting, Scorpion grabs Katana and takes her back to the Emperor.
Suckers!
Nah, 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 nah! Meanwhile, we cut to Sonya, who looks like she's pretty busy breaking into Jurassic Park, trying to find more pointless fight scenes to partake in. She comes across her counterpart named Jax, who just had the best steroid injection he ever had in his life.
All right, stand back, let's see what I'm made of.
Whoa, it turns out I'm made of awesome! But a lost G.I. Joe action figure comes in to make their escape a little tougher.
I come free with any Happy Meal.
So ninjas come in as we partake in, gasp, another fight scene!
Behold my accessories, they are all sold separately.
Be careful of what you hit, one of those buttons might zap Timmy on the electric fence.
My batteries are not included, motherfucker.
Okay, seriously, how many jump scenes can you have in a friggin' movie? It's like they're fighting in a trampoline factory. Look at these ninjas, the foot soldiers were more threatening than them.
A sun chop!
So Sonya finds some sort of flammable molten milk or something and blows it at the Tweety Bot, roasting him alive.
This is not covered by my guarantee.
Then they have to rush out of the building for the biggest, most incredible green screen explosion you've ever seen in your life. You know, guys, you don't have to blow up everything, especially if you don't have, the explosion! Meanwhile, Liu Kang roams the desert, searching for some form of life that can help him get Katana back. Instead, he comes across an obvious wolf effect that they could not afford. That 2 seconds of mediocre special effects is known as Night Wolf, a Native American warrior who looks suspiciously like Spirit from G.I. Joe, and is just about as hammy.
But to beat Shao Kahn, you've got to pass 3 tests. First one's courage.
I don't have time for these stupid games!
Oh, well, that's not good. The second challenge was stupid games. So Nightwolf tries to help him discover his inner beast by showing him past clips from the other movies. That would bring out anybody's raging inner beast. Look, he's turning into the Hulk!
You wouldn't like me when I'm Liu Kangry!
What Liu Kang didn't know, apparently, is that when you find your inner beast, hot, half-naked women appear to offer themselves freely to you.
With you, Liu Kang, I'm not afraid.
I can clearly see that.
No!
My heart belongs to another.
Your heart belongs to another? Who? What, Katana? That chick you've known for less than an hour? How does she own your heart? True, you just met this other woman, but give her a few minutes and you will have known her just as long. Unfortunately, the young lady doesn't take rejection well, as she transforms into a fearsome ninja and starts whooping Liu Kang's ass. Is it okay if we go back to having sex? So it turns out the young woman's name is Jade, and she was just testing Liu Kang. Yeah, that's it. To see if he would give in to temptation. He doesn't, so I guess she's joining him on his quest. I don't know, makes about as much sense as anything else. Meanwhile, we see Sonya and Jax as they too roam through the desert. There they come across, here's a big surprise, someone else to fight!
Katana? You wish.
Oh, glad to meet you, you wish. I seriously cannot believe how many fight scenes there are in this movie. I mean, look at this, it's just two women fighting each other, covered in mud. Heaving their large-breasted bodies onto each other, touching one another. Rolling around, grabbing each other's hair, getting all dirty and messy mud all over their bodies. forcing their clothes to cling to their skin ever so tightly, revealing their slim feminine figures for all of us to see, biting and clawing at each other, giving into their animal instincts, clawing one another like cats, and hissing and screaming until one of them comes out victorious.
Dirty little kitty, aren't you? Just a dirty, dirty little kitty. Yes, you are. You're di- Oh, yeah.
So after that scene, Sonya defeats Yuwish and is suddenly attacked by, Bowser's anorexic sister, but is saved by Jax, who puts that computer-generated sock puppet in his place. Meanwhile, we see Raiden talking to the gods as he tries to figure out how the Emperor went against the rules of Outworld and Mortal Kombat.
Ah! A scene without fighting! Take it away! Take it away!
Raiden then rejuvenates himself, trying to pull off the Billy Idol look, as he meets up with the rest of our heroes. We find out that our heroes have to travel to Outworld to rescue Katana, and I guess remove the spell from her mother that makes her all vampire-ish. Faster than you can say, STOP FUCKING FIGHTING! Another fight scene pops up, as we see Raiden split from the team to take on some more ninjas. So are you guys gonna hit each other, or...? Could you maybe stop doing flips and actually attack one another? Will somebody just throw a punch?! Crying out loud, this isn't Mortal Kombat! It's Mortal Ballet! Well, I had enough of this fight. Let's see how the other guys are doing fighting the vampire chick. Hey! What, you fought her off screen? Are you telling me that I missed another possible girl-on-girl action scene? What a ripoff! But they're fighting in Jell-O too. So Liu Kang breaks into the fortress to rescue Katana. I guess it looks like smooth sailing from here. Whoa!
It's a trap, Liu.
Oh! Thanks! Were you gonna tell me that before or after he cut my head off? So Liu Kang fights the worst Spencer's costume he ever saw and gets Katana out of her cage. Here, Katana tries to use her magic to break her mother from the Emperor's spell. But her magic doesn't work, as the Queen escapes their grasp by doing her Wonder Woman twirl. So, what now?
If Sindel is not the key to closing Khan's portals, then Khan has a higher allegiance.
Wait a second. That tattoo, I've seen it before.
It is a permanent mark that allows safe passage through the portals for the bearer and his passengers.
You know, I think I just figured out one of the major problems with this movie. There's no story. There's just explaining. How do we stop Khan? Let me explain. Where do we go next? Let me explain. It's just explaining and fighting, and I get enough of that from my own government. So please, explain to us why you have that tattoo.
My father is an elder god.
If your father's an elder god, what does that make Khan?
Shao Kahn is my brother.
Alright, enough of these cliches. Let's just jump to the final fight scene where our heroes face off against Khan and his warriors. But wait a minute, why isn't Raiden coming? Oh, I know. Perhaps he has some sort of foolproof backup plan to sneak in and stop the Emperor taking him by surprise. So, tell us, Raiden, God of Lightning, what's your strategy to help our team?
I will pray for you all.
Fuck you! Get your ass in there, Thor! I mean, what, is he literally standing somewhere in the back shouting,
"Don't worry, I'll bravely watch you die from the sidelines!"
After he does some serious soul-searching, Raiden does finally come to his senses and fight his brother. Finally, a groundbreaking epic duel. God versus God, brother versus brother. An incredible battle that will no doubt be the highlight of- Why were you even in this movie?!
Game over, Suckality.
Alright, so our heroes have to deliver the big fight as they use their martial arts skill to their full potential.
Best death ever.
It's up to Liu Kang to stop the evil Emperor now, but in what way should it be decided?
Will be decided as it should be.
Immortal Kombat!
Hell yeah! Mortal Kombat!
But Liu Kang gives into his inner beast and becomes whatever the hell this is. But so does Khan, who magically transforms himself into a giant. Okay, how can we take this seriously? How would the duck have better effects than this? So Liu Kang, of course, defeats Khan, his father turns into a Rubik's Cube, they get Katana's mother back, restore order to the world, and they live happily ever after. Or do they?
Yeah, they do pretty much. But I don't! I mean, this movie makes the first Mortal Kombat look like a masterpiece! I mean, nothing in this movie makes any sense or has anything resembling positive entertainment.
So does that make the first Mortal Kombat a good movie? No, but it definitely makes it a movie.
Which is more than I can say for this pig shit!
If you have a chance to pass it up, do so. And never look back as long as you live.
Oh, I'm the Nostalgia Critic guy, remember it? So you don't have to.